Welcome to Restriction Rules, the 10th video in the Who Sees What series. These videos provide admins the basics on visibility and data access in Salesforce. In this video, we'll learn about restriction rules and how to apply them to records in your Salesforce org. First, let's see how restriction rules fit into the big picture of security and data access. After you've set up org-wide defaults, sharing rules, and other sharing mechanisms, you can apply restriction rules that act like a filter to further refine user record access. A restriction rule is a setting that enhances your security by allowing certain users access to specified records. They prevent users from accessing records that may contain sensitive data or information that isn't essential to their work. Records can be filtered by criteria that you specify, and restriction rules have a number of useful applications. In this example, AW Computing has two customer service departments. One department is a team of service agents who only work with business customers. The other department handles all the other customer service calls from individuals. Here, they can apply a restriction rule that filters out task records for business customers from individual customers. But before we see this restriction rule in action, let's take an even closer look at how restriction rules work. A restriction rule is made up of user criteria and record criteria. User criteria identifies the users that a rule applies to. Record criteria specifies which records are filtered based on the current level of access. For example, if a record is the child in a parent-child relationship and you want to restrict access to some child records, then a restriction rule is a perfect option. Or if your existing sharing mechanisms grant too much access, filter that access with a restriction rule. Before a restriction rule is applied, a user has access to records based on organization-wide defaults and other sharing mechanisms. After a restriction rule is applied, user record access is further filtered to only those records matching the rule's record criteria. Okay, let's get back to AW Computing. They have a department of service agents who only help business customers. The call center manager wants to make sure these agents stay focused on these specific customers. This scenario is a perfect candidate for a restriction rule. Applying a restriction rule will block all other task records from the business-based service agents specified in the rule's user criteria. In this case, they won't see all the task records, only the ones they need to assist business customers. Let's apply the rule to a task. In Setup, find Object Manager, then select Task. In the left-hand column, click Restriction Rules, then create New Rule. Name the rule Tasks Owned by the Running Users Department. The API rule is auto-populated. Under User Criteria, in the Criteria Type drop-down menu, select User Criteria. This rule will rely on a field on the user record and identify users it applies to. If we were using a custom permission, we would select permission criteria. Under field, click find a field, then select department, click choose. In the value field, type business customer service agents to identify the department. Now you've set the user criteria to identify members of the business customer service agents team based on their user record. In the record criteria section, under field, click find a field and select assign to ID, user, then department. Click type and select current user. Click value and select department. Save the rule. We've just done two things. We've set user criteria to identify members of the business customer's agents department. We've set record criteria to task records owned by users identified as business customer agents. Let's see what a business customer agent user's report looks like before applying the rule. Now, let's turn on the restriction rule and see the difference. Back in Object Manager, select Task. In the upper right-hand corner, click the gear-shaped settings icon. Then check the Is Active checkbox to turn the rule on. When we navigate back to the Business Customer Service Agent Users Report and refresh it, records that don't match the current user's department are gone. Great, now we know how to apply restriction rules and we've seen them in action. Before you give it a try in your Salesforce org, here are some things to consider. When creating more than one restriction rule, configure the rules so that only one active rule applies to a given user. If you create two active rules and both rules apply to a given user, only one of the active rules is observed. Like other sharing settings, once an active restriction rule is placed on an object, end users don't see records that are filtered out of features like list views, lookups, reports, and related lists. The number of rules you can create per object varies based on the edition your org uses. Restriction rules are available for custom objects, external objects, and some standard objects. If you want to use them, make sure all your users have lightning experience. Check Salesforce help for the currently supported standard objects. To learn more about visibility and access, check out all the videos in this series. You can also search for these topics in Salesforce help or come join us on the trail at trailhead.salesforce.com. Thanks for watching.